In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create the ink transition in After Effects, so let's get to it. So here we are in After Effects. I've got two videos on the timeline that I'm going to transition between, and the first thing we need in order to create the ink transition is the actual footage of the ink drop. I'll make sure to include the video of the ink that I'm going to use in this tutorial into the project file, so you can download it for free from the link in the description. Or if you want to use a different ink, feel free to Google it and find the one that you prefer, and the rest goes as follows. So once you open After Effects on your timeline, make sure that you overlap videos like this. So once the second video starts playing, there is still the first video underneath on the timeline. Then once you add the ink into the project panel, drag and drop it to the timeline and place it above the second video. Make sure you align it properly like this. Then you need to open the track matte settings. If you don't see this track matte colon, click toggle switches and mode until you do. And then set the second video's track matte from the dropdown to whatever the name is for the ink drop. And then if you're using new versions of After Effects, you'll see these two boxes to the right. By default, the first one is set to alpha matte, and we need to click on it once until it says luma matte is selected. Then into the second box, make sure you click on it as well until it says matte is inverted. So if you're using older versions of After Effects, this pretty much means that we've set the track matte of this layer to luma inverted matte. And now what that does, it will create a cutout into the first video that has the shape of the ink. And inside of that cutout, you'll see the second video revealing. And if you preview this, you will see that we have a very nice ink drop transition. And in order to adjust the ink drop or the transition, you can simply select the ink file on the timeline, say press S on a keyboard, increase its scale to make the ink bigger. Also press P on a keyboard and change up the position to give it a different angle. So that is completely up to you. So I'll leave those at default. Now let's say you wanted to reveal entire video sometime after the ink is animated, say at 3 seconds. You can do that by first selecting the second video. Press Ctrl D to duplicate it. Make sure you bring it all the way up on the timeline. Make sure that the track matte of it is set to none. Then while this video is selected, press T on the keyboard, you'll see the opacity. And let's say at 3 seconds for me, I'm going to create a keyframe for opacity and set it to 0%. Then I'll move, say, 1 or 2 seconds forward. Let me do 2 seconds and then set opacity to 100%. And what that does is if you preview this first, we will have the ink transition. And as the ink spreads further, you'll see that at some point we will get the full reveal of the second video. So that's how you create the ink transition in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.